pro-Iranian government supporters clashing with opposition protesters, the violence erupting at a funeral for one of two students killed during a rally on Monday. In Bahrain, police firing on protesters. Yep, they're firing now. Watch that. On the protesters during a third day of rallies in the capital that left one person dead, thousands crowding the main square calling for political reform. And protests spilling over into Libya. People there want the prime minister ousted, but not their ruler, Muammar Gaddafi. CBS correspondent Laura Logan, beaten and sexually assaulted by a mob of men while covering the political uprising in Egypt. CBS says a group of Egyptian protesters attacked Logan in Tahrir Square while she was shooting a piece for 60 Minutes. Just a week before she survived a night of being held blindfolded by security forces, Logan now back in the U.S. in the hospital and recovering. A shooting in northern Mexico leaves an American immigration agent dead. Another agent is hurt. Jaime Zapata, who was part of the human smuggling unit in Laredo, Texas, and the other agent were reportedly attacked driving a government SUV between Mexico City and Monterrey. A Mexican investigator says that they may have stopped at a phony army checkpoint. The injured agent is in stable condition right now. Well, he says the banks knew. Convicted con man Bernie Madoff speaking out for the first time since his massive Ponzi scheme was revealed. Madoff telling the New York Times, quote, "They had to know, but the attitude was sort of, if you're doing something wrong, we don't want to know." Madoff didn't specify which banks might have known about his $50 billion scam. The 72-year-old is now serving a 150-year prison sentence. And he did go on in that interview to say that his family still did not know, but the banks did.